brother, it's Monday on Omoito. Till this moment, just recently, sir, if maybe you don't know, that a student, a 100 level student of Uniben was recently raped. And it is in accordance to that, we say, okay, fine, there's need for us to express disconnected from the insecurity
in this country
at a whole.
Yes.
We have cases of illegal mining in Osun State, we have cases of kidnapping, we have cases of students cannot sleep with their two eyes closed. And that's why we need to express our displeasure. And as law abiding citizens, if you see people, sir, you realize that we have our face mask, we have our nose guard, we have our sanitizer, just to make sure that we don't breach the law of the land. We have spoken with the Commissioner of Police, and the area commander is also aware of our doing. Although they said we should not have, but they were there, we promised them that the needful will be done. We are glad today that the police is here and they are ready to address us. In fact, not just to address us, the police is willing to support us. Am I correct, sir?
Yes.
That the police is willing to support
yes.
us, that we actually find justice to rapists. I mean, no rape at all in our society. We should not in any way condone insecurity. We should not in any way condone illegality. It is important to note that an injustice to one
is an injustice to all.
Luther continues.
Victoria Sata!
Okay, you are the cameraman.
Yes, sir.
Oh. Ah, the cameraman.
Our major protest is not basically for war. There are future occurrences that will happen. If we don't express our displeasure today, if something worse can happen tomorrow,
who is not,
who has not the first, who is not the second? In that series of rape, in fact, real times, sometimes last year, reported a story of a cleric that raped a 15-year-old girl. Nothing happened. The man was not even investigated at all. So if you now tell us that because they are handling the matter, in fact, I think that should not be the base of argument. But rather to attack as much as possible. So, no total security. My comrade here has more things to say.
What are we looking at now?
Thank you very much. Yes, we have to appreciate your presence here.
You're the boy. Really, when we talk about security in Nigeria, we all know that we cannot do.
We have the issue of police brutality that has almost become a menace in Nigeria. And I'm sure some of us are even aware of what's happening in the United Kingdom. Where a citizen was killed. But just that citizen has led to protests for about 7 days. And even as at last night, the American citizens were about to enter White House when they had to be dispatched. So in fact, we are just, this is after about thousands of victims that have happened. And we just will be gathered in our mouth. And I think on that note, we will deserve a round of applause. So on that note, we also understand the fact that we are in a sensitive period. And there's a need to do things in order and accordingly. So on that note, we have even written our petitions that we aim to submit as well. So presently, okay, this is the decree. Yeah, we are actually heading to the Moria police station now to submit the petition. And we also want to submit one at Crown FM to be the media.
And that's
what we want to do. Yeah, we will even be glad if the police can even follow us and what
okay, the okay, let me help us here. All this you have said is true. But I want us to, like, really talk. Yeah, I mean,
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
God bless the Nigerian police.
God bless the students. God bless.